Good morning, good morning, good morning. This is your 5 a.m. wake up and breakthrough. We're going to ignore the fact that we're starting a couple minutes late because I completely knocked over everything because it's 5 a.m. in the morning. And that's what happens when it's 5 a.m. in the morning. We want to welcome everyone who's joining us for 5 a.m. wake up. I hope you have your morning tea, coffee, some kind of natural energy stimulant, and nothing horrible from late nights for early mornings. Welcome, Nana. Thank you for joining. It looks like we have quite a few people joining us this morning. Welcome, Tub Corp One. This looks awesome. It's so good to see so many people up this morning. I'm not the only one. Who else couldn't sleep? I was up at 3:15 staring at the clock, feeling like I was going to constantly miss this call this morning. So I was being special. Anyone else feel like that? Just me? It's all right. It's early in the morning. You can type in on your screen. I promise the camera won't switch to you, so we'll never see you. But I definitely want you to engage. This is your opportunity to not listen to Naketa Thigpen talk, but to ask questions, to share your concerns. We want to wake you up and have a breakthrough this morning. You only get 5 to 10 minutes, so we want to make it quick so you can get back to the things that matter most. Thank you, Jack, for joining. EGS, thank you for joining. We see quite a few people. This is awesome. You can always, for those of you who are new to Periscope, on your screen, you can tap right above that little white avatar. You can add hearts if you agree with the things that I'm saying. If you just want to engage in a different way besides typing on, feel free. Awesome. The heart colors will come up different for all of you. So let's get some color going. This is good. This is good. If you have a sister, friend, brother, cousin, anybody who you want to join in, make sure that you swipe to the right so you can add that person, whether they're on Twitter or dialing in from their cell phone. They do have to be a part of Periscope, though, so if they're not today, make sure you tell them later. All right, well, let's get started. I want to jump in because, again, I apologize we're a few minutes late because I literally, right as I was typing the title to this 5 a.m. wake up, I knocked over everything trying to get to my tea. That's what happens. It's all right. It's real, you. You see this? No makeup, nothing but a little stud. It's 5 a.m. This is raw. This is real. This is your 5 a.m. wake up. I hope you're looking forward to it. So earlier in the breathe room, probably a few days ago, it might have been Friday or Saturday, the breathe room is something that I do on Facebook just for anyone who's a part of our 10X Focus Tribe. You can join too. It's free. It's just a private closed group where we talk about different ways to pause, things that are going on in our life, ways to handle it. We share pictures from vacation. It's really good stuff. Very small, intimate. No one can see it. It's a secret. I had a aha moment that occurred for me last week, probably at 2 o'clock in the morning, while my husband and I were just talking about our own breakthroughs and different things that have occurred for us in our life and some of the inhibitors and issues that have come up and how so many of those goals we set, things we wanted to achieve, whether it was for me, you know, tightening and toning, getting stronger, because it's not about losing weight for me. It's just getting stronger because I have a health issue and I'm tired of it kind of winning over me on different levels and being a major barrier for me. It became something that was done in the past, like that thing we did. So we kept thinking about, you know, this was an issue. We couldn't, you know, for him, it's not losing weight either. It's just toning or tightening. We had things in our business that were goals that we wanted to get done. And all these things started out as really great achievement opportunities. We set them. We set out plans. We completely overcomplicated everything by just being a scheduler who was taking things way too far to the left. And before we knew it, it became that thing that was supposed to get done in the past. And I was looking at myself and him as we were having this conversation, trying to figure out, as intelligent and smart and creative as we are, what's our barrier? Well, we know the answer to that. The barrier is yourself, of course. But I looked a little bit deeper, and I had to be real with myself and say, I didn't want it bad enough. I didn't want to get stronger bad enough. I think about the idea when I'm having some struggles in the morning, if I can't hold a cup fairly well, or if there's some issue with my muscles, or, you know, whatever the case might be. But I clearly didn't want it enough. I wasn't starving for it. I didn't want it bad enough if I wasn't really willing to persist and push through. So I thought about all the different people in my life, from professional to personal, all the way through the circles of life that I had, and all the kind of common areas that we go through and say, oh, I want a relationship, I want to get fit, I want to start a business, I want my business to go to the next level, I want to move up in my career path, I'm tired of this job, I'm tired of this department, I don't want to be in this division anymore, even if I like the company, which is rare for people to say, but it may happen, and all these different elements that might come up with that. However, I have to challenge you with the question of how bad do you really want it? And I'm not picking on you. I said the same thing to me clearly less than 72 hours ago. And I wanted to make this the first 5 a.m. wake up and breakthrough because it hit me really hard. And I know that even though I have a whole plan for every day this week and for the next 12 weeks, actually, for all these specific topics that I want to cover to energize you, I needed to start hard and hit you where it hurts, which is you. You have to really look at what you want. How bad did you want to get up this morning? Is this one of those things that you're laying in the bed right now? No shade. That's okay. I'm all right with that. I would prefer to be in the bed right now. Is that one of those things? Welcome. Go through it. We appreciate you joining this morning. Is that one of those things that you definitely, you know, sat there and said, oh, I hope I can make it, but I don't know. You know, if I do, if I don't, I hope she has a replay, whatever. Are you supposed to be at the gym right now? Should you be on your way out in 10 minutes? Can you lay on your floor and just do some, you know, ankle rotations and stretch your body out, if nothing else? Are you supposed to be working on a book? Are you supposed to be writing something? Is there a new position that you're going after at work that you really want? And you know you have some things that you have to improve on in your life and in your career for you to meet the goals to make you, you know, eligible, to make you stand out for that next position, for that next proposal if you have a business. What are you lacking in your life that's not allowing you to do it? I challenge you to think about your hunger, really. How much do you want it? Do you want to sit around all the time and consistently say like, oh, you know, I used to play tennis. I used to be a size, I don't know, 8, 6, 10, you know, whatever is your preferred body weight. I used to be able to run a marathon. I did that back in the day. And then you look at pictures and you're liking them on Facebook or Pinterest or Instagram or Twitter of all these people you wish you could be like. What's stopping you from hitting that next level for yourself? You really have to wake up and break the barrier that is you. The same thing I had to go through, I go through it on a regular basis because I'll achieve these 10 goals and I'll say, oh, well, those other five, you know, I wish I coulda, shoulda, and it turns into all those elements of it, but why not? Why not reach your wish, your coulda, shoulda, and make it a reality? What's stopping you from doing it? Is it the man? Is it the woman? Is it your kids? Is that your excuse? And I do challenge you to say that that is an excuse. That is not always a reality. I'm sorry, my babies are no longer babies. They will always be babies in my mind, but they are 18 and 14. Guess what, girl? You can get up and go to the market in the middle of the night if you need to. They are safe. If they were 2 and 5, obviously you wouldn't do that. You would need to have some support. If you need to go to the gym and you can't get there because you have a 6-month-old at home and maybe your spouse has a different work schedule, so that's not ideal for you to wrap up your babies, interrupt their school schedule or whatever their sleep schedule is to do those things, there's something invented called YouTube. Turn it on. Chromecast it to your TV if you need to. You don't even necessarily need anything beyond internet. And I know you have it because you're on this smartphone right now and you're constantly checking your Twitter. So that's not an excuse either. Whether you're into a Beachbody fitness, at-home yoga, Pilates, you just need to turn on a lamp, grab a pen, open your notebook and get to writing. Whatever your goal is, you really have to look at what is preventing you from getting there. From this point A that you're at and you're kind of teetering and tottering, slowly walking over to point B versus actually getting there and being very straightforward. Thank you, Nana Emma 75 for joining this morning. I love these Twitter names, by the way. They're just like incredibly easy to say. Shade, that was shade. But ThigPro isn't easy to say either. It's really ThigPen's professionals and no one can say it. So we just say ThigPro, how about that? Thank you everyone for thinking about, yes, go through it. You're right. You have to remove the excuses to get back on track. You're 100% correct. You got to remove all the excuses out of your way that includes you and all the things that are stopping you. I'm just going to pick on me. I'm not going to talk about my clients. I'm not going to talk about friends. I am only going to talk about me, Naketa Thigpen, CEO and president of ThigPro, life management and professional development company, empowerment speaker, author, mom, wife, minister, amazing, incredible woman when I'm not in my own way. Let's talk about her. How about the excuse of not eating healthy? Now, I eat really, really clean all day long. There are so many things that I can't have, so it's not a joke, it's not a diet, it's not me trying to look cute, though that's a nice default of it, honestly. But that's not why I don't eat gluten. That's not why I don't eat high fructose corn syrup. That's not why I don't eat anything that's modified or GMO, corn, starches, anything. That's not why. I would love to be at a friend's house. I was just after church on Sunday sitting, and my sister was cooking wonderful pasta meals. Everything was good. People had cookies and all. I would love to just sneak a little piece of a cookie or do something, but that's not healthy for my body. So I eat really, really clean. My challenge is I don't eat enough. So I had to sit with Naketa Thigpen and say, what is wrong with you? Why are you not fueling your body so you can be balanced? Because if I don't have fuel inside, obviously my energy is not going to be what it needs to be. I'm not going to be as sharp cognitively as I need to be for all the millions of things that I do. And I'm not special, but I am a special spice, but I'm not special. I do a lot compared to, quote unquote, the average person. And I still have a lot to get done in my life and even in my day. But if I'm not fueling correctly so I can literally infuse, pun intended, infuse balance into my life, then that's causing an issue. So as clean as I eat, as much as I drink a nice, even peppermint tea or black coffee with no sugar, no cream, no nothing, and I'm only drinking water all day long, if I'm not drinking enough of it, that is a problem. That is clearly an issue. So you can't justify like, oh, well, I do all these other things right 90% of the time. I need to drink more than 6 glasses of water. How about that? You have to have discipline. Absolutely. Yes, absolutely. You have to have discipline. You also have to look at the ways you can improve your life. I had to look at, okay, what makes me thirstier since I'm just like naturally not very thirsty and you can go your whole day not really drinking anything. If I exercise early in the morning and all I need is a good 20, you might be an hour, hour and a half person. That's not me. That's not what I need in my life. That's not what my schedule allows on an average day, although I have some, you know, heavier intensive days or not. I love to rebound on a trampoline, pull it out. In 2 minutes, I'm sweating. In 10 minutes, I'm sparkling glitter for somebody. But for me, it's disgusting, drippy sweat all over the place, which feels good for me. I look forward to sweating. I don't have hair issues. I don't have to wrap it up or do anything special. So I look forward to sweating. It feels very purifying for me. 20 minutes a day is all I need. Maybe not a little extra stretching on the mat after we're all done. But if that helps me drink more, why am I not doing that more? I have to look at what's my excuse for doing it. So I sat with my husband and I told him, I'm like, with our schedule with 3 here, 4 a.m. here, 6 a.m. here, traveling, you know, all the different things we do, my excuse will become, well, you know, I went to bed really late and I only have 4.5 hours, or maybe I technically had 7 hours of sleep, but I wasn't really asleep because of the anxiety of the next day, all the thoughts that were running through my head. I know some of you can relate to that. I know you go to sleep and don't feel rested. I know you lay your head down at some point during whatever part of the day you're supposed to lay down, morning or evening, based on your work schedule, and you have a hard time shutting it off. I know that because I know you, because you're like me. And I know that you're like me because you wouldn't have joined this broadcast if you didn't have some of the same challenges that wake me up in the middle of the night. We attract each other. That's why you're on 5 a.m. club all day. I also know that you're probably up way before 5 a.m. Even if you're laying in your bed when you're up, you're just not necessarily up, dressed, you know, teeth brushed, face washed, moving around, but you're up and you're not sleeping well and you're thinking about your day. You're thinking about what didn't get done yesterday. You're thinking about all these things you do and all these things you have to do and all these things that you did already, but they weren't as great as you would have liked them to come out and the way that you want them to go in the forward. I already know it because I know you. Sorry. Like, you can say, like, Naketa, you never met me in my life. It doesn't matter. If you were attracted to this, there is something in common that we share, and I can say I know you well enough to say that. If you disagree, feel free, type it on the screen. I am always up for a challenge because I guarantee you that I know well enough that you will only get up at 5 a.m. to hear someone tell you how you need to get to your next level and break through the challenge that is you because of those things. Because you know that you're not, go through it said, we all go through it, no pun intended. I think that pun was intended and I love that. We do. I don't care how special and smart and brilliant, sexy, fit, wonderful you are, you're human. And you have to tap into that humanness and say, okay, I see my weaknesses. I see where I can get better. Maybe I have the tools. Maybe I don't. Maybe I need to get a coach, a mentor. Maybe I have them, but I'm not being honest. Pause. How about that? How many of you already have your circle of influence that are not only people you influence, but that influence you and are supporters? They may be mentors and advisors. Some of them, you know, could be family, really close people, could be professional peers that you really value their opinion. So you technically feel like, well, I have someone to go to if I really want to, but you don't. You're not being fully honest. I challenge you to think about the fact that you're not being fully honest because you're not being honest with yourself. It's not just you not wanting to share your deepest, you know, most inner dark ocean depth secrets with this person because at the end of the day, they are another person and you don't want your information to get out there. Maybe you trust that that won't be the case, but you know, there's just some temperament around it. You don't want to open up Pandora's box for some things you haven't challenged. But what about opening up with yourself? What are you not being honest with you about? I can honestly say that I wasn't honest with the fact that I had a fear preventing me with all this clean eating, with all this food, with all this exercise, all this stuff. I was really challenged by the fact that I was worried that I wouldn't be able to keep up all the things that I needed to do to be the healthiest me I could be. And again, it's not about losing weight, tight and toned. Like that's not my focus. Mine is all strength. I want to be able to hold my freaking toothbrush in the morning and not have an issue because of my disorder. Sometimes I really can't hold my sometimes I can't put lotion on my body. I have to wake my husband up at whatever time in the morning and say, can you do this for me? Because I have to leave the house and I can't do it. And it's beyond a zipper issue. Sometimes I literally can't do that. And that's a major issue. So all the clean eating, all the exercise in the world, that's all helpful to a degree. But my biggest issue was I didn't want to start something and not be able to keep it up. I also didn't want to be that girl. I say that to my friends who are really close to me all the time. I hate being that girl. I hate being the girl that's in the restaurant that has to explain why she doesn't eat something. It really irritates my soul, truly. So I will say I'm gluten-free with no apologies. I won't even explain anymore. Someone's like, oh, you don't eat gluten? No. Why? You know, do you like not eating gluten? Yep. Mm-hmm. Yep. Like everyone thinks it's about a diet. They think I'm trying to be a part of some trend or some fad. It has nothing to do with that. So my thing was I had to look at why was I not being transparent? Why was I not being as open as I could be with friends and family who could support me? When I'm going to dinner or I have to set up a meeting, why am I not necessarily choosing a place that could accommodate me versus trying to accommodate the other person because I didn't want to be that girl? Of course, I would still pick things that were relevantly good for what I needed to do and to make sure that I wasn't going overboard. I never, you know, put myself in harm's way, but I wasn't necessarily being as protective and careful as I should have been. If you can relate to that, tap the screen. If you know that you have some fears blocking you and you're not being as transparent as you should be with your mentors, advisors, your closest friend, your intimate partners, tap the screen. I see you and I thank you for the hearts and I thank you for joining. And I hope that this morning, this moment of clarity for you that you hopefully could relate to, and I know you do because I know you well enough already, just in this last little 10 minutes, I know you well enough to know that you understand restless nights, not being able to shut off the noise in your head, not being able to be as honest with yourself because you're afraid to admit what is really keeping you from your next thing and not making that thing something that you shoulda, coulda, woulda, but making it something really awesome. I do want you all to have a productive day. Thank you, go through it. This is going to be an excellent day. You're going to walk into your next moment rejuvenated, refueled, energized, and you're not going to turn off this screen, this live stream, and go to sleep. You're going to get up and get your book and your pen out and get to work. Write down what's blocking you and make a plan to prevent it. Tomorrow and the next day and the next day, we'll go a little deeper in different levels and we'll really hit everything that we need to. Enjoy your day. And if you want to go a little bit deeper, tune into the Balance Beam podcast. We talk about these topics with industry experts all the time. And they're 30, 45 minutes conversations, not the 10 minute version that we're doing here. Until tomorrow with the next 5 a.m. club, wake up and breakthrough. Enjoy the balance of your day.